power, defined by many as having the ability to do or to become, to have dominion and authority, to possess potential with no limits. Welcome to the Power of Jesus' Name broadcast.
Well, the Lord bless you real good. We're in the middle of Resurrection Day. I know by the time you see this telecast that you'll say the resurrection is over, but it ain't over till God says it's over. Got a good word for you today. The Bible says that when the angel told the women, you'll go tell his disciples. There was one disciple that was ashamed outside of the grace of God. His name was Peter. But the Bible says, tell the disciples and Peter. Can I tell you, you're on the list. In fact, you're next on the list to be blessed. Title of the message is, He's Risen and You Are Forgiven. Come on, hear this word. Word of the Lord today in the book of St. Mark. It is in the 16th chapter, and we begin our reading today at the 6th and 7th verses. And he said unto them, Be not affrighted. Ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He's not here. Behold the place where they laid him. 7th verse, but go your way, tell his disciples and Peter that he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him as he said unto you. I want to lift up two words out of the 7th verse, and Peter. The whole phrase says, tell his disciples and Peter. I want to talk today from the subject, the grave robber restores the rock. I want to use for a reoccurring theme, he's risen and I'm forgiven. The grave robber is Jesus. He's the rock of ages. He's Christ, the solid rock. The disciple who denied the rock of ages was a man called Peter. The text states that the angel was to tell the women to tell my disciples and Peter. My brothers and sisters, I submit to you today that you and I ought to be grateful because he included us. Yeah. Peter, in overconfidence, said to the Lord one day, I will never deny you. I'm your ride or die guy. Jesus said, before the rooster crows three times, you will deny me three times. When Peter denied the Lord didn't rebuke him. The Lord didn't call him no names. He just looked at Peter. How many know a look can bring conviction? Can I get a witness today? Some of you that were raised back in the day when children were disciplined, you were acting up in church, and all your mama did was just give you a look. And you said, oh God, I'm going to die today. Can the church say amen? Amen? Jesus just looked, my brothers and sisters, at Peter. And Peter ran away with the other disciples. But how many know that when everybody run away, God will still be there? Amen. The women brought the news, but they did not believe the women. Mother Durham, but I stopped by to tell you earlier today that they didn't believe the women, but it was true anyhow. Right. Let's examine the profile of this man called Peter. His father's name is Jonah. He had a brother by the name of Andrew. His occupation was a fisherman. Contrary to Roman Catholicism, he was not single, but he was married. Because of the fact that Jesus healed his mother-in-law. Not only was he a fisherman, not only did he have a family, but he was a homeowner. And then not only that, but he was the first of the apostles to be called. Isn't it marvelous that God included you? I dare you to shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, after all you've done, you're still on the list. Hallelujah. After all the mess, y'all ain't here, that went on in your life, God said, what you messed up, I clean up. Y'all ain't gonna talk with me today. Amen. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, don't get cute on me. Amen. And don't get all proud on me, because all have sinned. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me today. Y'all got your pretty hat on, you got your stuff on, but I'm telling you that if it had not been for the Lord, as if it had not been for the Lord, anybody here got something in your past that you need forgiving for? Hallelujah. There's some folk, amen, that no matter what it is, they ain't gonna forgive you. They'll go to their grave with stuff in their heart. But I ain't gonna let nobody, you ain't worth, y'all are helping me. You ain't worth, you don't own that much space in my mind for me not to forgive you. I heard Jesus said, when you pray, say, our Father, God in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses. My God, shake your neighbor's hand and tell him, I'm not perfect, but I am forgiven. Come on, find another neighbor. You had the wrong one and say, and you ain't perfect either, but you are forgiven. Peter was in distress because he know he done wrong. I'm looking at too many people sanctified. Somebody, too many church folk up in here today. Too many Pharisees stand back at me. But I'm going to preach anyhow. Uh-huh. Check your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, any use of me fronting, I know I was wrong. Y'all ain't gonna help me through here, but Jesus took my wrong and made it right. Should I preach while I'm preaching? Amen. Tell your neighbor, find somebody that look like they love God, and just tell them, I messed up. Y'all were choking when you said that. Some of y'all don't want to hide your stuff, but just find somebody that look honest. Y'all will help me and say, I messed up. But he cleaned it up. He washed me whiter than snow. Should I preach now? What kind of man was this Peter? Amen. Number one, he was the confessing Peter. Jesus had a Bible class one day. At the end of the Bible class, he gave a quiz and said, who do men say that I, Son of Man, am? They said, some say you're John the Baptist. Others say you're Jeremiah. Others say that you're Isaiah, or one of the prophets. Peter wasn't sure, but he raised his hand and said, thou art the Christ, Son of the living God. Somebody said, confessing Peter. Somewhere yonder in the book of Romans, it said, if you confess with your mouth and believe with your heart, you shall be saved. And he that believeth and is baptized, the same shall be saved. I wonder, would you put your arms around your neighbor and say, neighbor, don't bring up my past. I've been restored. David wanted me to tell about 17 of y'all, he restoreth my soul. He walks with me through the valley and through the shadow of death. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Holler across the aisle and say, he's risen, and I am forgiven. I confess that Jesus is my Savior. Let's take the second look at Peter. He's a confessing Peter. And not only was he confessing Peter, but he was a cussing. He's a cussing disciple. When they ask him, do you know Jesus? He said, I done told y'all once. Y'all are helping me. There's a few saints in here this morning. If you get them backed up, they'll cuss. Y'all ain't gonna help me. Don't look at me like that. Hallelujah. You hit your hand and say a word that you're talking about. I didn't mean to say that. But how many know it don't come out if it's not in there? He was a confessing Peter. He was a cussing Peter. Y'all ain't helping me. He was a cutting. Y'all are helping me. Peter would cut you. Y'all ain't gonna help me through here. They were at the garden. It was at the garden, and Jesus was trying to keep things calm down. And the high priest servant came for Jesus, and Peter just happened to have. Y'all ain't helping me. Happened to have a sword in his hand, and he said, "Nah, we ain't going out without a fight." There's about five people. They got something on the hip right now. I can't tell you who they are, but don't start nothing. Y'all ain't helping me. Shake your neighbor's hand and said, don't start nothing up in here, and it won't be nothing. Peter looked at the man and said, that must be the one that's going to hit my Savior. While Jesus was trying to calm Peter down, amen, Peter already had, y'all are helping me. Y'all ain't talking to me. He already had the sword in his hand, and when he brought it down, he was aiming for the head. He was going to cut the man's head off. But somehow or other, the sword slipped and cut the man's ear off. Y'all are helping me. I don't know. I said, I don't know whether Jesus stooped down and got the old ear and put it back on the stump, or whether he just made another ear and put it on the man's side, because the ear was evidence. Y'all are helping me. If indeed, can I preach now? If indeed the ear was cut off, it was the high priest's servant, amen, somebody was going to jail. Y'all ain't helping me. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, amen. I should have been in jail. I should have been behind bars. But Jesus destroyed the evidence. Say, yeah, Lord. Somebody came to me the other day and said, Bishop, before I got saved, I was arrested so many times, but God delivered me. Y'all ain't helping me. Shake your neighbor's hand. Amen. I got a rap sheet this long. I'm supposed to be behind bonds, but Jesus took my place. Y'all ain't gonna help me through here. Shake your neighbor's hand like they're gonna shake it off and say, neighbor, where's the evidence? Said it's already been destroyed. If the glove don't fit, you got to quit. Y'all ain't helping me. Why don't somebody break down in this house and say, yeah? Come on and say, yeah. Shake about three people's hand and say, after all you've done, and you know you're wrong, God said, you're on the list. You're on the list for salvation. Find about three people and say, he included you. Yes, he did. Shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, after all you've been through, God still loves you. Give him praise. Good morning, y'all. Good afternoon. Happy Resurrection Day. Give him a loud praise. That ain't the praise. That's an Easter praise. Give him a resurrection praise. Yes. Yes. Give him glory. Give him praise. He's a grave robber. Say. Say yeah! Oh, say yes. Find about three people. Say he's a grave robber, but he restored me. Yes. Oh, say yes. They hung him high. Y'all don't want no preaching. They stretched him wide. He hung his head, and then he died. The the way. The story ends. Say yes, I give him praise. Give him a high praise. Give him a better praise. I'm still waiting on a real praise. Get up on your feet and go to scream at me. I got the victory. Oh, I got the victory. Say yes. Walk across the aisle and say, neighbor, he lifted me up from my grave. After Lazarus died, he said, it ain't gonna end this way. Give God the best praise. I like a good ending. Y'all ain't helping me. I like a good ending. Some of y'all like these stories. You don't know whether they died or lived. Did the man get the girl? Did they go riding away in the sunset? Did the princess get the prince? Y'all ain't helping me. Tell somebody, don't leave me like this. I need a good ending. Check another person's hands. I ain't going out like this. I got to have a good ending. And he that began a good work in you will perform it to the day of Jesus Christ. Say ya! Say yes. Find three people. Put your arm around them and say, you ain't going out like this. Come on, hug them. Say, not like this. Not sick. Not lame. You ain't going out. Not like this. Jesus is on the way. High five your neighbor and say, he's on the way. Hold on. I gotta break these in. Hold on a little while longer. Say yeah. Give God praise. Good morning. Come on. Good karma. Say yeah. Shake your neighbor's hand. Say, don't worry about a thing. He's on the way. When he got outside of the city, Mary came running. Martha came running. If you had been here, my brother would not have died. Jesus. I ain't got to be helping to say Jesus. Jesus said, Mary. Can I call her Mary? I believe I could call her a little louder. Ah, Mary. Mary, I think I can call him a little louder. Help me, Inez. Oh, Mary! Mary, don't you weep. Martha, don't you moan. Yes! Yeah! And he said, your brother gonna live again. And Martha looked at her notes. She said, in your last Bible class, you said that there was going to be a resurrection. Jesus said to Martha, I am the resurrection. I am. I'm stuck on I am. I am Rapha. I am Jehovah Jireh. Y'all better leave me alone. Shout hallelujah. I'm the first and I'm the last. Say yeah, yeah, yeah. Jehovah Rapha. Jehovah Tiskenu. Oh, I am. Oh, Yes, I am. And under this head, oh my God. You don't want to see him now. Y'all ain't helping me. Anybody got a perfume? Somebody shout hallelujah. Anybody got a Chanel? Hallelujah. Anybody got any Jimmy Choo? Anybody got anything? Yeah, how much you spent for this? Good amount, yeah, okay. They said, if you go into the grave, you better take some spray with you. He's been dead. Thank you. He's been dead, and he's sticking in the grave. Why don't you break down and say, oh my. Tell your neighbor, you coming out of this smelling good. Jesus says, show me where you laid him. Shake your neighbor's hand. Say, when was the last time you saw your problem? Show me where you laid it down. Say, yeah. Give God the best praise. I say, give him 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 the best praise. That ain't the praise I'm waiting on. Take his jacket. Take the sleeves. And tie him up. Y'all ain't helping me. Look at your neighbor as a neighbor. My life was tied up. Tied tight. That best you can do. They've wrapped him. Y'all ain't helping me. Give God praise here. Give him a better praise. Cause he's worthy. He's worthy. I wish I could preach like I wanna. Say yeah. Come on and say yeah. I need you to time up some more. I know your suit, you just got it. Hallelujah. It's an old one. Yeah, that's what you say. Hallelujah. Time up. I said, time up. I don't want him to be able to move. That's what I'm talking about right there. Time up. Time all the way up. Come on and shout hallelujah. Time. I need another tire. Y'all ain't helping me. Tie him up. Hit him around about the ankles. Because I want to tie him up. Y'all ain't gonna help me through here. Come on, make a good knot. Hallelujah. Head tied. Some of y'all here today, devil got your head tied. Y'all ain't helping me. That's why you need to take off them do-rags. Y'all ain't gonna help me through here. That's why the police stopping you. Cause you got a do-rag on. You need a do-Jesus. Come on and shout hallelujah. Say yeah. Give God praise. So Jesus stood at the grave of Lazarus and said, roll the stone away. Say yeah. Isaiah was in the grave. So he's a wonderful counselor, a mighty God, and the Prince of Peace. Job was in the grave, saying, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Jeremiah was in the grave, says, just like fire shut up in my bones. Oh! Abraham, down in the grave. Ezekiel saw a wheel in the middle of the wheel. All of them was sleeping in the grave, but Jesus stood at the grave and said, Lazarus, not Isaiah, not Jeremiah, not Job, not Abraham, sleep on, sleep on. You'll get ready in the first resurrection. But Lazarus, tied up, came a hopping. Come on, church. Came a hopping, came a hopping. Out the grave, came a hopping, came a hopping, came hopping, 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 came a hopping. Out the grave, Jesus said, loose it. Loose him. Loose him. Ah, loose him. And let him go. Good morning, y'all. Good afternoon. Good evening. Good God Almighty. Y'all can get up in the first resurrection. Give him praise. Say yes. Give him praise. Give him honor. Cause he's happy to be praised. Tell your neighbor, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, we shall be changed. Get on your feet. Scream. Holler. Shabbat. That ain't no praise. That ain't no praise. Get the real praise. Go find 8 people. Say he's risen and you are forgiven. This is Apostle Huey L. Rogers, and we want to say thank you to all of our partners for listening and viewing. Thank you so much, our dear sister from Elmont, New York, sending a large gift. May God bless you is our prayer. I want you to know that in the month of April, I'm going to be in Connecticut. The numbers will be on the screen. It'll be a Kingdom Building Workers Conference of the Bible Way Church worldwide. Be blessed. Until next time, know that you're on the list. And not only that, he is arisen and you are forgiven. If the Lord should bless you to have a monetary gift for the praise, for the power of Jesus' name, there's a number on your screen that you can get the sermon you just heard, or you can just send a love gift in to say, may God bless what you're doing. Until next time, this is Apostle Huey Rogers saying, no matter what goes on, what goes down, there's still power in the name of Jesus. See you next time.
Power of Jesus.